I'm gonna help you master stitching through really thick, thick layers with a couple little tips. Like when you go over a really thick jeans hem, for example. So I'm just starting off by sewing two layers of denim fabric together, and then I'm gonna open them up and then we're gonna start to fold this. So this is where you really start to pile up the layers when your seam is folded two times. And then right here, because of, let's say, 1, 2, 3 times 3, that is 9 layers of fabric. And what happens is your foot kind of goes up and over. Sometimes you get long stitches as you're trying to get over this. Now this machine does have some fabulous capabilities with, for example, the IDT engage. It's just gonna pull that right on through and go up and over nice and evenly. Now before we totally get to some extra tips, I am going to show you a little something, like a little cheat version. You have the foot 3 in with your accessory box, and we're gonna do a quick little top stitching with it. That little red marker is adjustable, and if I wanted to, I can move it left or right. What I'm gonna do instead though is I'm gonna just move our needle position just a little bit to the side and add a little top stitching. Now let me show you why I love this foot, because it allows me to keep a nice even top stitching without really thinking. I'm just guiding the fold right next to that little marker, and I don't even have to really think much. It really just does everything for me. Look how straight this seam is, and I didn't even have to do anything. I just opened it up and ran that right even with the fold. So that's one thing I like. If I wanted it a little bit further apart, I could have moved the needle a little bit more over to the side. I could even adjust that little mark to be one way or the other, more or less. So that's just a quick little side note. I love showing that part of the machine, because that foot comes with this machine. All right, so next, let's take our fabric and we're gonna do those two folds. Now, normally I would wanna have like a denim needle in the machine, and I will confess I don't have that in the machine right now. We're just gonna use the needle that comes with it. But we are gonna have you, I'm putting the needle back to the center position. We're gonna take out the multi-purpose tool. And then the next thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make sure that we sew from the top. And that is why we call it top stitching, because when we top stitch, you have a prettier stitch on the top of your fabric than you do on the back. And that's because that needle has to kind of travel through all the layers and it comes out where it feels like coming out. Sometimes looks a little crooked, but if you sew from the top side, you're always going to have that pretty stitch. The other thing I'd like you to do is lengthen out your stitch length. If you leave it at 2.5, the stitches, when you get really close to the thicker area, are going to start to look really tiny. Let the machine pull the fabric through. So by lengthening out, you can even do 3.5 and that works really well. Set the needle to stop in the down position, okay, and you'll see why in a second. So if you have a seam that you can't get up and over, that's where this tool can come in. With the needle down, I am gonna raise the presser foot up and you're gonna bring the tool underneath the foot, but just up to the seam. So then when the foot comes down, it's like it's leveled out on the back. Now this foot is way up here on the top of the plateau of the seam and doesn't have any problem keeping those stitches nice and even. Same thing when you come off the seam, you can put this tool in front of the needle. Of course, don't go too far. I have seen people in my classes stitch through this tool. And yes, your machine will go right through this, no problem. There is also a thicker side and a thinner side. So I was just using the thinner side for right now. But if you had something really thick, you could use this side, put it underneath and balance out that foot so it's not uneven. And boy, does it just give you such a nice seam when you're all said and done. So let's take a look at those stitches. That's what we're looking at, and how nice and even in stitch length they are, even though it was going over something really, really thick. Now you can kind of sort of see that the threads look like they have a little jig to them, not much, but if that was on the front instead of the back, it definitely could make it not look as pretty. So top stitching from the front, a jeans needle would be best because it has a sharper point. Love the multi-purpose tool, and if you want to do some awesome top stitching, pull out your foot number 3 and move your needle position.